family ancestry back for generations.
I believe in peace, you know, our family, the Maori people bring in peace, tolerance, love. You know, if I can say to the world, I love you, it will be the gold card for the future, for the new millennium.
On a remote island chain with just 750 inhabitants, the millennium has also sparked a race to be first. Monique Croon and Dean Braid plan to be the first to tie the knot at 12.01 a.m.
I thought, well, I'll ask Monique and see what she thinks. I asked her to marry me, and she said yes. I mean, I told her, well, can we do it at midnight? And yeah, so that's how it all come about.
Hopefully on the stroke of midnight we say I do. Yep, so that we are the first.
Also planned here, the first horse race of the new millennium, the first haircut, and the first fishing competition, after which this rugged group of islands, 800 kilometers off the coast of New Zealand in the South Pacific Ocean, will return to its customary obscurity. Mike Chinoy, CNN, the Chatham Islands.
Time now for a final look at the forecast with Eric on East Market.
Well, we certainly enjoyed some bargain late December weather today. Now, we will have a front approach the region during the overnight period and first thing tomorrow. So as we wrap up 1999, we'll see clouds mixing with sunshine throughout the day tomorrow. The 5 day will bear that out. And then the first day of the year 2000 should feature a mix of sun and clouds as well, with temperatures throughout the weekend warming well back above seasonal averages. Have a good evening.
Thanks, Eric. That'll do it for us this afternoon. We'll see you back here tomorrow.
Stay tuned now for Dateline 29 News at 6.
Y2K bug or not, Virginians are preparing for what happens after the clock strikes 12 tomorrow night. We'll tell you how.
Hundreds of Central Virginians are looking for new jobs after Value America cut its workforce in half yesterday.
And military personnel get some extra help from Uncle Sam. We'll tell you about that. The news starts now.
This is Dateline 29 News at 6.
Good evening, I'm Dave Kopp.
And I'm Stacey Horst. The countdown is on for the start of the new year.
And while some are making plans for a night out, other people are stocking up to deal with that other event of the century, the Y2K computer bug. Ariana Malamy joins us now. She has more on the who's and how's of Y2K preparedness. Ariana, how worried are people about the Y2K bug?
Well, Dave, from what we saw and heard today, it looks like people don't really think anything bad is going to happen, but they'd rather be safe than sorry.
Not really afraid of anything happening. We usually buy our drinking water anyway, but we just got a few extra jugs just in case something should happen.
We have a generator, yeah, just like as if we're expecting a snowstorm. Yep. Just be prepared just in case.
While the lines at the stores are getting a little long, the banks say they haven't seen any extra traffic.
So far, it's been quiet, and we've been very prepared. You know, we work with the Federal Reserve very closely, and we are in constant contact with them.
Now, Smith says the best thing you can do is not panic. If you want to have some cash on hand, just take out a couple of days' worth and have a copy of last month's bank statement just in case.
All right, Ariana, thank you. Augusta County authorities believe they have thought of everything in preparing for the year 2000. Ken Slack tells us what Augusta residents can expect on New Year's Eve and after.
Can you 1025 Route 11?
After midnight Friday, Augusta County's 911 center will field emergency calls just as it does right now. The county's confidence comes from upgraded computer equipment and two backup power systems. The Augusta Government Center will house a special command center New Year's Eve. Authorities will monitor all county functions while keeping close contact with Stanton and Waynesboro.
That's not uncommon in any situation involving emergency services, particularly we realize that if there is a problem, a people-related problem or whatever the case may be, Augusta County will assist Waynesboro or the city of Stanton, and we know that they stand ready to come assist us.
Augusta Medical Center spent 2 years addressing the Y2K problem. The hospital has upgraded or replaced nearly 800 computers and has backup systems for electricity, natural gas, water, and communications. The Department of Transportation says its equipment is ready to go, from computerized dispatching of snowplows to the 120 traffic lights in the Stanton District, including Augusta County.
We can actually dial up the intersections and monitor their operation, and we'll start that at 12:15 Saturday morning. And I can dial all the intersections in Stanton District and to make sure that they're working.
12 VDOT technicians will also be on the street just after midnight Friday to visually check all traffic signals. In Augusta County, Ken Slack, Dateline 29 News.
Well, we have been giving you a lot of advice on preparing yourself for any Y2K problems.
But have you given any thought to protecting your pets? Tara Nuren tells us what steps you should take just in case.
Okay, so we're pretty sure the world's not going to end this New Year's Eve. And the experts are telling us the Y2K computer bug won't cause any catastrophes, in this country at least. But just in case something electronic does go wrong, wouldn't you like to know your pets are taken care of?
Make sure you have plenty of water for your pets set aside in case the power goes out. You want to make sure you have dog food, cat litter.
If you run out of pet food for dogs, you want to have something that's bland that they can eat. Boiled pasta, boiled white rice, pre-boiled white chicken without the skin. Those are things that if you had to change diet, it would not cause an upset stomach or intestinal tract. For cats, tuna fish, which is canned salmon. They can have canned chicken, jarred baby food of liver, beef, or chicken.
You should keep hard copies of your pet's medical records and upcoming appointments, and be sure to fill up any prescriptions your pet needs. You'll want to have extras on hand in case your pharmacy runs out. Keep a collar and ID tags on your pets, and have a picture handy in case your pet gets lost.
And people who work with animals say you should have some of these around, blankets, not just to cover up your dog or your cat, but for your horses, your rodent cages, and yes, even to cover your fish tanks. In Albemarle County, Tara Nuren, Dateline 29 News. And in the off chance that you are forced to evacuate your home, try to take your pet with you. Have an emergency kit on hand and find out ahead of time where your pet will be welcome.
A multi-car collision tied up traffic on Hydraulic Road for several hours this afternoon. Police say a Jeep hit a car that had pulled out onto the westbound lane of Mickey Drive. The Jeep then rolled into a Ford Explorer that was waiting for the light to change. The driver of the Jeep was taken to the hospital. There's no word on the condition of the drivers of the other two vehicles. Charges are pending. And hundreds of Charlottesville area residents were looking for jobs today.
Just yesterday, we told you about internet retailer Value America's plans to eliminate nearly half of its 600-member workforce. Now, former Value America employees must find new jobs. And as Keenan Howell tells us, it might not be that difficult of a task.
It's a New Year's resolution employees of Value America hoped they wouldn't face, finding a new job. Company executives laid off 47% of the internet retailer's workforce yesterday, and the reactions of those former employees have been mixed.
There are some people that are very upset. I'm not, really.
And he's not alone in his lack of emotion. In fact, one Charlottesville business owner says it couldn't have happened in a better place.
Charlottesville is undergoing a tremendous high-tech boom right now. Companies like mine and many others are very eager for their talents.
Steve Friedman's DBD Group helps get new e-businesses off the ground. The entrepreneur says there's more room than ever at the growing internet business table.
Computer programmers, to tech support people, to network engineers, to people that just know how to handle daily business at a high-tech venture. And those are what we need.
Value America executives say they're telling those who've lost their jobs how to find new ones. And for many, that's their only wish for the coming year. In Charlottesville, Keenan Howell, Dateline 29 News.
Virginia's active military personnel will certainly welcome the new year. They're getting a tax cut. State leaders held a press conference at the Virginia War Memorial to explain what the tax cut would mean for those in
uniform.
What
this bill does is it gives tax relief for the first $15,000 of basic military pay, and then there's a phase out up to $30,000.
Military tax cut is a way to give a little bit back to those who give so much. It's a way to recognize that Virginia appreciates the strong military presence. It's a way to encourage those who muster out of the military forces to stay in Virginia, and a way for their families to encourage them to stay.
Policymakers also announced that they will attempt to pass a resolution to name the soon-to-be Interstate 895 bridge the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Bridge. That structure won't be complete until 2002. Great day today. Temperatures were about 15 to 20 degrees warmer than yesterday.
It was amazing. I was driving around with the pickup. I had the air conditioner on for a while because it was out in the sun. It's crazy. We had highs in the 50s today. To find out what's ahead for the last day of the century, we'll check in with Robert Van Winkle in our Dateline 29 Weather Center.
Well, today was indeed quite special. Tomorrow won't be quite as nice, but we're still in for a pretty warm trend for this time of year. I'll be right back with the forecast after this.
Some things have a way of changing your whole outlook, like the Chrysler year-end event. Because now you can drive the 300M with 0.9 APR for over $5,000 in finance savings. The Chrysler year-end event. It can have a profound influence on you. Buy 300M with 0.9 APR for over $5,000 in finance savings.
There's enough food to feed everyone in America. The economy is booming. Americans are living longer than ever before.
GM Superstore with the largest selection in the area. Hundreds of Pontiacs, Buicks, Cadillacs, and GMC trucks. Sign and drive with no money down. This Pontiac Montana, only $359 a month. Plus up to $2,000 cash back or 2% over invoice. Got a brand new 2000 Buick Park Avenue. See us today.
Holidays are sprinkled with delight. Rich and warm. Golden and wrapped in tradition. They embrace many cultures and bring together family and friends. These times that bubble with cheer. These times that dance with lights. These are the times we treasure most. From the Giant family to yours, may your holidays be delicious.
If a Toyota and a Honda could gossip, you know what they'd talk about? The Mitsubishi Galant, the car that beat the Camry and Accord to become Car and Driver's number one family sedan for under 20 grand. Buy it now with zero down, zero payments, and zero interest for all of the year 2000. Somewhere, a Camry and an Accord comfort each other. Hurry, the 000 till 01 event ends January 3rd.
Is it hot in here, or is it just them?
Wow.
What are you smiling at?
I'm sorry, that was so sexy.
Hey, what? I want to put something on.
Like a record?
Like a teddy.
God bless you. Jesse. Oh my God.
The temperature's rising on Jesse, NBC Thursdays.
Well, we're talking about some big numbers today and not just the temperatures.
Now, we're closing out our holiday charity for this year.
That's right. Kids Cafe was our designated charity this year. And a lot of you folks, I think, who probably never heard of this effort are now well in tune with it and have shown some great support. So we have a few folks we'd like to thank as we wrap things up. These generous people I've heard from today and yesterday, hi to the Scottsville United Methodist Women. Thank you very much. And some folks I have already been thanked, but I just have to thank them again, especially the employees at Crutchfield and many, many other people who have come up with some very big bucks for us. Finally, as we look at the last numbers, I think you'll see that we are very pleased to give Kids Cafe, the project of the food banks in this area, $16,043.80.
Wow. That's terrific.
And to the lady who wrote the check for that, with that 80 cents on the end, you know who you are, so that's where your money is right there. Anyway, folks, thank you. God bless. It was wonderful. And the kids are going to be reaping the benefits of your generosity for many, many months. So, there we are. Thank you very much. 61 degrees in Charlottesville right now. Humidity at 38%. Southwest winds, the barometer 29.83. Can you believe this weather? I mean, it was downright hot for this time of year. 64 for the daytime high. Average should be 46 degrees. Here's a little tidbit. The average temperature on April 10th is 64 degrees. So we're a couple of months ahead on the calendar. But it's not going to stay this warm for very long. It never does in December, so don't get too used to it. In the Shenandoah Valley, it's 59 degrees still, 36% humidity, southwest winds. There's the barometer at 29.83. What's going on across the area? Temperatures today warmed up like this, 64 in Charlottesville, 63 in Orange, 64 coming in Buckingham County at Dillon, even 47 at Wintergreen, but plenty of snow in the higher elevations has already been made by Massanutten and Wintergreen. All the ski resorts are in good shape, and lots of great skiing this holiday weekend if you'd like to get out in the slopes. It's warm weather, that won't hurt them at all. Daytime highs, 58 in Waynesboro, 59 in Stanley, 62 in Gordonsville, and 64 from Lake Monticello. What's going on? Well, we have a weather system approaching us that will bring us clouds for the last day of 1999. There you can see the cloud cover moving toward the state, but this isn't a storm by any stretch of the imagination. As a matter of fact, it's just sort of a response to a little disturbed area of weather down here, a front to the north of us. It's all going to push through and probably not do much for us at all. As a matter of fact, on New Year's Eve, we're expecting just a few clouds, probably in the morning, overcast conditions, breaking up a little by tomorrow afternoon. Wouldn't be surprised if there were some sprinkles to the northern part of the state, but otherwise, it looks pretty dry for us. Temperatures tomorrow will be not too bad either. Even on New Year's Day, as we start 2000, this system swings off the coast, and we just get a few clouds. It's looking pretty good. Here's your forecast for tonight. 36 degrees. Cloud cover will be thickening up with west to southwest winds. For tomorrow, 53 degrees. The cloud cover will keep us from getting into the 60s tomorrow, so if you're expecting a day tomorrow like you saw today, I don't think so. We're only going to get in the 50s for tomorrow afternoon. And for the valley, same thing. Low 50s, variable clouds throughout the last day of the year. Into 2000, here we go. Y2K or not, it'll be about 56 degrees on Saturday afternoon with a overnight low of 32 degrees. And again, smooth sailing till the first of next week. I think maybe Monday night, Tuesday, we'll see some rain with the next system. So still pretty mild for this time of year, obviously.
Okay.
All right. Thank you, Robert.
You bet.
And still ahead tonight, we'll go inside the courtroom for a look back at some of the high-profile cases of 1999.
From the murder of an Albemarle County gas station clerk to what could be the first execution of the century in Virginia, when Dateline 29 News continues.
Individually, they are standouts in their respective classes. Collectively, they paint a portrait of daring and innovation. Characteristics that produce groundbreaking vehicles like Dodge Caravan. Right now, you can get a cash allowance of $1,250 on the most innovative, most imitated, most trusted, and best-selling minivan ever. If you're ready to move in a different direction, get to the Dodge year-end event today.
Try Rapid Photos, the oldest, most experienced one-hour photo lab in Charlottesville. Now, when holiday pictures are so important, it's nice to know you can use your photos to create the very best in greeting cards and gifts. Rapid Photos offers expert service and the latest technology. Let us restore and improve your photos like magic. We'll repair damage and create new photos by adding or eliminating elements. We also process Advantix film and print digital images on photographic paper up to 12 by 18 in color or black and white. Rapid Photos, new technology combined with traditional service and quality. North Wing Barracks Road.
During the past 100 years, Ford's made automotive history countless times. And to bring the 20th century to a close, we're doing it again. Presenting 20th century clearance at your local Ford dealer. Now's the time to get into a new Ford car or truck. With clearance financing as low as 0.9% or cash back up to $1,500. Even special lease offers. Get to your local Ford dealer today. Because when 20th century clearance ends, it's history.
It's the end of an era sale at New York Carpet World. Up to 50% off carpet, 50% off pad, plus no payments and no interest till 2001. It's the end of an era sale at New York Carpet World.
Once in a while, a car comes along that's really worth pursuing. A car with features like an automatic transmission, alloy wheels, ABS, a security system, and more. All offered at a price that has proven to be very elusive. Of course, you have to see such a car to not. Would be criminal. The Special Edition Accord from Honda.
Now get APR financing as low as 3.9% APR for 36 months on new four-cylinder Accord sedans.
When severe weather hits, Storm Team 29 is there. We'll have live reports, up-to-the-minute weather forecasts, and all your area school and church closings at sunrise, noon, 5, 6, and 11, and anytime on the World Wide Web. We have the information you need to know, so get connected with Storm Team 29.
And we continue our look back at 1999 tonight with a look at legal battles and high-profile criminal cases.
The year in courts featured a stay of execution, a mistrial, and a host of guilty pleas. Meredith Grabois has more.
It was almost like a Law and Order episode. The Shell Station murder case featured twists and turns only a TV show could emulate. Three young men, all accused of robbing and killing an Albemarle County convenience store clerk. The alleged shooter, 16-year-old Carlton Arnold, is tried and convicted, but the verdict is later thrown out. A second defendant, 18-year-old Isaac Brown, also stands trial, but before the verdict is read, he pleads guilty and agrees to testify against the other two. And finally, a jury hears the case against the third defendant, Dylan Tyree. But the 12 men and women can't reach a verdict, and the judge declares a mistrial.
The jury worked very hard for 9 hours, 3 or 4 hours yesterday and 6 or 7 today. They worked very hard. It was obvious that they had worked hard at it. They couldn't reach a decision. We're just going to reset it for another day.
The year in courts also featured lawsuits over a landfill, cell towers, and police misconduct. A former Albemarle police captain pleads guilty to child pornography charges as a former Orange Town manager admits to sexually assaulting a child. And a countess avoids a guilty plea once again.
I'm perfectly aware that I am not politically correct enough for Charlottesville. I'm not well liked. I am perceived as a femme fatale, I suppose.
The fate of others accused of murder is not as clear. Leroy Spinner faces first-degree murder charges for allegedly killing his wife and burying her body in a shallow grave. His trial is scheduled for next year, but time may be running out for Steve Roach. Convicted in 1995 of capital murder, he was once the youngest person ever to sit on Virginia's death row. Roach's execution was scheduled for August, but the state Supreme Court postponed it to hear an appeal. That appeal was denied, and Roach now awaits his new date with death, January 13th. And that's a look back at 1999, the year in review for courts. Meredith Grabois, Dateline 29 News.
And next in sports, in less than an hour, the Cavaliers will be meeting up with the Fighting Illini in the MicronPC.com Bowl.
Gary Cope is up next with the details of the big matchup.
Tasty at McDonald's? For a limited time only, the mouth-watering McRib sandwich is back. A juicy pork sandwich smothered in a savory barbecue sauce with onions and pickles all on a warm bun. Hot, fresh, just for you. And only at one place. Did somebody say McDonald's?
People call it smart. Thrilling. The place for values. Toyotathon 2000. The blockbuster event filled with great Toyota values. Your ride to the new millennium is here. Are you ready to go? Now, you can lease a Camry sedan for $209 a month for 39 months with $2,109 due at signing. Get to Toyotathon 2000. Now playing exclusively at your Toyota dealer.
Rodentrack says the muscular V6 gives it undeniable appeal. Open Road says this SUV is an all-star player. It's the V6 Grand Vitara from Suzuki. And we say now it can be yours for $255 per month. Visit your local Suzuki dealer today and drive one home for just $255 per month. Find out why Motorweek says the Grand Vitara is the best small SUV of the year. And it's only at your Suzuki dealer.
It's our spectacular New Year's Day sale at the Fashion Gallery. We will be open New Year's Day from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. for an event you can't afford to miss. You'll find great quality selections, all up to half off. Reductions throughout the store for ladies sizes petite 2 to 22 and men. It's a great sale from 11 to 5 New Year's Day at the Fashion Gallery, Route 11, Verona. We will be closed New Year's Eve to prepare for this fabulous Fashion Gallery New Year's Day sale.
Best in initial quality, Dodge Dakota. Best minivan, Honda Odyssey. Best buy, Dodge Caravan. Best coupe, Honda Prelude. Brown Honda Dodge, bringing you the best. Honda's best, Dodge's best, and Brown's best. The car, truck, van, or SUV you want, new or used, on your terms. Brown's best. You'll love it.
Brown,
you love the service.
What's the manager's special at McDonald's? Two Big Mac sandwiches for just $2. One bite into the Big Mac's two all-beef patties, special sauce, lettuce, and cheese, and you'll fall in love all over again with this McDonald's classic. Hot, fresh, just for you. Did somebody say McDonald's?
It's almost bowl time for the Cavaliers. John Havey is there. Gary Cope sitting in tonight.
That's right.
Yeah, he's down there, and I'm here.
At 7 o'clock, that's the big...
We've been talking about it for the past 5 weeks, ever since, you know, they finished the season, and now the time has finally come. Cavs fans here, Cavs fans in Florida, are all ready to get this thing underway. They're tired of talking. They're ready to get things going.
Yeah.
Time has finally arrived. Put up or shut up for both the Cavs and the Illini in about 35 minutes. UVA and Illinois will kick off the 1999 Micron PC Bowl. And now these two teams are very similar on paper. Both are 7-4. Both needed three-game winning streaks at the end of the season to make it to this bowl game. And John Havey takes one final look at these two evenly matched teams before the 7 o'clock kickoff.
Now that the day of Virginia's battle with Illinois has arrived, the Cavaliers have pulled themselves away from the sun and fun of South Florida to concentrate on football. Now here's what the Wahoos are facing from the Illini. Offensively, U of I featured a balanced attack this season. The running back tandem of Steve Havard and Rocky Harvey combined to rush for more than 1,400 yards and 13 touchdowns, while quarterback Kurt Kittner, who was just a sophomore, threw for 22 more scores against just 4 interceptions.
They have a big, strong offensive line. They like to, you know, establish a running game early. They'll come out and try to run the ball down your throat. And then Kittner's had a great year. He's a very consistent quarterback. He, you know, he completes a lot of touchdowns, hadn't thrown a lot of interceptions. He's a very smart quarterback. He doesn't make a lot of mistakes. So we're going to have to come out and try to shut down the running game first and foremost, and then be able to put pressure on Kittner. I believe if we can put pressure on him and show him some different schemes he may have not seen, then we should be okay.
Now, when the Illini defense is on the field, they know full well what Thomas Jones has done to opponents this season, so look for 7 and 8 men near the line of scrimmage to try and slow TJ down.
That's what a lot of teams have been doing this year, and just trying to gang up on Thomas, and towards the second half of the year, we really made them pay for that, so that's what we're going to have to do this game, and we're looking forward to having a big game with the passing attack, and hopefully we can just keep the momentum that we've had through the second half of the year.
Now, it's been a while since the Cavs beat Maryland to close the regular season, and Coach Welsh is concerned about how the team's going to handle the layoff.
You know, that's the one thing about bowl game. You can judge during the season, you know, how the team's going to show up at bowl games. You know, it's been, at least 5 weeks since we played, so I don't know what to expect.
I'll tell you what I'm expecting, a good show from the Cavaliers. From Fort Lauderdale, I'm John Havey.
Thanks, John. The women's basketball team hosted Butler yesterday on day one of the nationwide Cavalier Classic. 4 teams, 4 games, 2 days. Now the Cavs, Radford, Butler, and Syracuse all going head-to-head. Well, not all at once. That would just be chaotic. Interesting, but chaotic. Maybe a sport for the future. We take a trip over to U-Haul where the Cavs hosted Butler in a Wednesday night game. First half, the Cavs moving the ball well. Renee Robinson drives, then dishes to Dina Mitchelson for the layup. 17-10 Cavs. Virginia playing solid defense at the other end. Sky LaRue denies the Kristen Bodine shot, and the Cavs come up running. Chloe Elias to Svetlana Bolnaya, back to Sky LaRue for the left-handed lay-in, and the Cavs are still up 7, but would only lead by 3 at the break. 33-30, more Cavs defense in the second. Lisa Hozak blocks the Kelly Kuhn shot right to Sky LaRue, and here comes the Cavs. LaRue ahead to Hozak. Nice spin move, puts up the pretty layup. Who's pulling away? The Cavs getting it done on the boards here. Sky LaRue comes down with a rebound and then fires up the jumper. That is good. LaRue with a career-high 29 points. Cavs going to win big, 88-54. And high school hoops, the final game of the Holiday Basketball Classic feature Albemarle Monticello in the title game. We pick it up in the first half. Brett Hardy for Albemarle comes up with a steal, pushes it up court, waits for his teammates, then finds Nick Sauer in the paint, a little contact, and Sauer cuts the lead to 1. It's 12-11 Mustangs still in the first. Billy Wilkerson to Monticello, passes to Trevor White, back to Wilkerson, and Billy pulls up for the 3, and it's nothing but net. 18-13 Mustangs in the second. The Patriots took the lead. Ryan Pahanik gets the inside pass and goes to the hoop for the lay-in, and the Albemarle Patriots going to win their 4th straight Holiday Classic title with a 56-50 win over Monticello. They have won 12 now straight games in this classic over the past 4 years. They're the dominant team. It's their 6th title overall.
Terrific.
Right. Thanks. Thanks, Gary. We'll be right back.
Some things have a way of changing your whole outlook, like the Chrysler year-end event. Because now you can drive the 300M with 0.9 APR for over $5,000 in finance savings. The Chrysler year-end event. It can have a profound influence on you. Buy 300M with 0.9 APR for over $5,000 in finance savings.
Happy holidays begin at the Charlottesville Ice Park. Bring your friends and family out to enjoy all of the magnificent fun we planned just for you this holiday season at the ice park. Celebrate the holidays with our extended public skating sessions offered daily now through New Year's. Surprise the skater on your list with skating school and hockey classes. Hurry and sign up now. Classes start at $50 for a six-week session and begin January 8th. Happy holidays do begin at the Charlottesville Ice Park.
Tonight, extraordinary women who made history.
We've never seen anything like this.
What happened to the women champions of the World Cup? NBC Nightly News tonight.
It's the final countdown. We must reduce excess inventory by December 31st. That makes the last 6 days the best 6 days of the year to buy at Colonial Auto Center. Get zero down, zero interest, and zero payments till 2001 on any new Mitsubishi sedan, coupe, or SUV. Zero down, zero interest, zero payments till 2001. Hurry, the final countdown ends December 31st.
Colonial Auto Center, you want it.
Tomorrow morning, get connected with the news you need. Dateline 29 News at sunrise.
Would you rather be a fake somebody than a real nobody? That's the question that Matt Damon's grappling with in The Talented Mr. Ripley. Hello, everybody. I'm Bill Duvall.
And I'm Kay Young. Tomorrow in our Feature Friday report, we'll review the newest Matt Damon Gwyneth Paltrow thriller.
We'll also have your New Year's Eve forecast and sports action. Join us.
Make the connection tomorrow morning. Dateline 29 News at sunrise.
Closed captioning for this Dateline 29 newscast is brought to you through a grant from Wolf and Farmer, attorneys concentrating in Social Security disability cases.
It's a big night for the Cavaliers.
Yes, it is, and we will have all the highlights tonight at 11 o'clock, and John Havey will help us out at 11 as well.
Sounds
okay.
Good.
NBC Nightly News with Tom Brokaw starts now. That's it for this edition of Dateline 29 News. Thanks for watching.
See you later.
Good night.
Crackdown on terror. Authorities say the suspects coming in from Canada are connected. More arrests today in Brooklyn and Boston as the countdown nears. Close call. An intruder stabs former Beatle George Harrison in a bloody struggle in his mansion. In depth tonight, New York City on high alert as it prepares to host America's biggest party in Times Square. And our series, Images of the Year, tonight. They were America's champions. What's happened to the women who won the World Cup?
This is NBC Nightly News with Tom Brokaw, reporting tonight from Times Square.
Good evening from Times Square. The year and the 20th century are ending in this country with a national effort to head off any threat of terrorism. And unfortunately, with more gunshot violence. We begin tonight with the concerns about terrorism that will continue right up to and through New Year's Eve. There were more arrests today, more suspects were questioned. So far, it appears to be mostly preventive measures, better safe than sorry. Still, it is a wide-ranging effort, and it is paying off. NBC's Pete Williams has the latest for us tonight.
An unusual nationwide sweep by federal agents starting early today in New York City to question anyone who may know about potential terrorist attacks. Federal agents also on the move today in Massachusetts, California, Texas, and Washington states. At least 50 people interrogated, 8 arrested, mostly on routine immigration charges. Federal agents tell NBC News it's all based on information coming from the investigation of Ahmed Rassam, the Algerian man charged with driving into the U.S. from Canada 2 weeks ago with powerful explosives. In New York, agents searched the house of Abdel Ghani, accused of meeting Rassam in Seattle just before Rassam was arrested. They accused Ghani of fraudulently using a credit card to help raise money for Algerian terrorism, then trying to cover his tracks back in New York after Rassam was arrested. And in a Vermont courtroom today, authorities publicly draw a connection between Rassam and Lucia Garofalo, a woman arrested last week at the border with Canada, charged with helping Algerians enter the U.S. illegally.
We have what I believe is a link between Ms. Garofalo and the matter in Seattle.
In court documents, prosecutors say